The title in English is The Stranding, which relates to a big section of the book. It's not ruining the book to tell you that there is a whale stranding in the book. So this is a story set on the beautiful, remote, wild beaches of the east coast of Australia, where you can walk alone on a beach and not see anybody else. And it's a story about recovery from grief and healing in nature, where somebody, a very broken man, in his 30s, retreats to a small country town, to a house at the end of a road on some cliffs above the ocean, to hide away and try to recover from a very deep tragedy. It's also a story of the grandeur and mystery of the whales that migrate along the coast in spring and in summer towards Antarctica, and the amazing spiritual experience of seeing those whales and how that can be a first step towards recovery. Grief can be so large that you never recover from it, but we have to learn how to put one foot in front of the other and keep on living. And in this story, for this particular character, Lex Henderson, seeing the whales is that first step. The first time he starts to feel excitement and positivity after being deeply wounded by life. And I write about these sorts of things because we all experience deep hurt and tragedy in our lives. It's inevitable. And my interest is in how we move forward from those things. I think that within nature, we can find the space to allow our souls to settle and to let, with the rhythm of the ocean, especially for this character, we can allow some of that grief to wash away, allow the hurt to come to the surface and perhaps begin to heal. We can look at the light, we can look at the patterns of movement of animals, birds and other creatures along the seashore. And in that space and looking at that beautiful light, I think there is a little seed that can begin to grow of recovery. I really think that that's important. I think we don't take enough time to go out in nature and give ourselves space away from all the technology and the busyness of our lives. And I think when we're deeply hurt that we need that space to recover. Well, my personal cure is either to go to the beach or to the mountains or even just behind my house up into the woodland and to sit and have that quietness, that contemplation, not necessarily to think, maybe to think, or maybe to allow emptiness to come into my soul and quietness. And in that space, I think I can begin to heal. I think one of the reasons the French people, this is my feeling and I might be wrong, but I think one of the reasons the French have responded to my books is that I believe the French people love nature and that they love wild places and appreciate that. And I think this is something they connect with in my books. So I studied French at school. I did 6 years of French. I loved it. It's a beautiful language. It's so musical and, as I said, very poetic. So I've always loved French. And I did travel in France 30 years ago. Loved it. I didn't have much money, but I ate a lot of baguettes and plenty of cheese and French wine. And I spent about a month traveling around France. That's all I could afford at the time. Spent 2 weeks walking around the streets of Paris and loved it. And now I've been learning French again at Alliance Française in my hometown in Canberra and helping my daughter to learn French. She loves it too. She's learning it at school. So it's a beautiful language. I think it's interesting, there's La Mémoire des Ombres, there's definitely some French connections there. So maybe that's why the French have enjoyed that book too. The French explorers like Baudin, d'Entrecasteaux, and the French botanist Labilladier were very important exploring the coastline of Australia and did a lot of, they described many Australian animals and plants. So there's a strong historical connection between France and Australia. And with lighthouses too, it was a Frenchman, Augustin Fresnel, who designed the lenses, the massive lenses that are in the big old lighthouses all around the world. He designed those lenses and they were designed and built in France.